Since the publication of his controversial debut novel, Trainspotting, in 1993, Irvine Welsh has enjoyed continuing critical and commercial success. He has also remained impressively prolific, working not just in literature, but also in theatre, film and television. His 10th novel, A Decent Ride, has just been published. I caught up with the Edinburgh-born writer during the Quirch Festival in Galway to talk about the book.
Welcome to Galway, Irvine, and this rather unusual location for a wet Saturday morning.
It's very old school, isn't it?
Do you frequent sex shops often?
I don't, no, I've never been there. Obviously when I wrote the book Porno, I kind of started to get into it. I've never been a great consumer of porn. You always feel like, I always get really depressed watching porn. You always feel like you kind of get crashed into somebody else's party, basically.
Right, okay. So you don't want to be a third party to...
It doesn't really kind of do that much for me, to be honest.
Your new novel is your 10th, entitled A Decent Ride. Can you tell us about it?
Yeah, it's about a taxi driver, a guy called Juice Terry, who was in my previous novels, Glue, Porno, and a short story called I Am Miami, in Reheated Cabbage collection. But he keeps coming back because I find him such a fascinating character. He's a total prisoner of his own obsessive compulsive disorders, and he's made them. His worldview is kind of formed by them, basically. You know, he believes that everybody has the same worldview as him. He's the kind of honest guy who admits to it and revels in it, but everybody else is basically the same as him, which is probably true in some ways. So he has this kind of massive sex obsession, he's kind of having as many sexual partners as he can, and that's his whole life. And then something kind of happens to him whereby he can't lead that life anymore, so he has to reorder his life, and it's about him trying to make sense of that. And there's all these kind of weird things and weird characters that are going on around him with their dramas that he gets enmeshed in.
The book features an American businessman who's a bit of a Donald Trump kind of character.
Yeah, the businessman type character is basically somebody who's as egotistical as Terry, but has all his money and his wealth, and he kind of expects, he hires Terry as a cab driver, and he expects that Terry will be in his world, basically, but Terry's just such a rampant egotist that the guy finds himself more in Terry's world than the other way around, so it's just, it's kind of interesting when you get people like that, that are kind of involved in this mad battle for kind of, this covert kind of power struggle. And the guy actually kind of become friends of a sort, which is kind of bizarre.
So Juice Terry Lawson, the top shagger, drug dealer and gonzo porn star, is he based on anybody you know back in Edinburgh?
It's funny because I had my mate Jimmy Anderson was taking me around. He drives a cab now and he was taking me around, and Jimmy used to have these big long kind of sort of perm kind of locks and all that, and I used to say, like, you know, just because this guy is like kind of drives a taxi, he's got the long perm locks, and he's an ex-Hibs football thug, and you know, it doesn't mean to say that he's based on you at all, but I don't think he was quite convinced. But it is more of a composite of kind of two or three people.
Your last novel, The Sex Lives of Siamese Twins, has just come out in translation in Germany and in Italy. So you're promoting that in those countries and then promoting this new book over here. Does that become difficult, sort of working between the two books?
It does. You know, you don't know whether you're kind of sort of talking about shagging taxi drivers or shagging lesbians in Florida and all that. You know, you can get a bit mixed up. But it's nice as well, because if you break things up, you know, you're in a different place, a different culture, you're different language, you're talking about different things. So I think that it's nice to have two things on the go at once.
There's been talk of a movie version. As a sequel to Trainspotting, and is that going to happen?
Yeah, I mean, it's been talked about this for years, ever since it came out 10 years ago. But the position's always been script. You know, we've always thought if we can get a good script, we probably will do it. If we can't, we definitely won't. You know, nobody needs the money, so we don't want to kind of trash the legacy. So it's important to us that if we do it, it's kind of on the basis of something that really adds to the whole thing. And I think that's where we've always been, but we've kind of we've got to the sort of point where we're kind of we are talking about it now, and the actors are now 20 years older than they were in Trainspotting, so we have to do something different. We couldn't base it completely on porno because things have changed since the internet porn kind of thing was a big thing. So we'd have to do something a bit different, and we'd have to make them also 20 years rather than 10 years older. So it's getting to that point that if we're going to do it, we probably have to do it within the next few years. So I think over the next couple of years, I think we'd probably announce, yes, we're going to do it, or no, we're not going to do it, you know. And I think it's probably about 50-50, you know. Unless we feel brilliantly about a script, we won't do it. But if we do, we will, you know.
A Decent Ride is really hilarious, but I mean, there are scenes of necrophilia and incest and whatever else, and given that, it might be quite hard to make a movie version.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a lot of things that you couldn't show in A Decent Ride if you were shooting it as a kind of movie or as a TV series, but I think there's a lot of things you could as well. You know, you could have a bit of fun with it. So, it's like with kind of anything that's adapted for screen that's quite out there, you have to be a bit creative with it. There's certain things that you don't really want to show, you don't really need to show either on screen.
Most recently, Filth was adapted into a big movie. So any other of your books about to be turned into Hollywood movies?
Well, I mean, I've been talking about, there's a script for Glue, which I think is very good. Which also features Juice Terry. There's a script, there's a couple of kind of Sex Lives of Siamese Twin scripts, which I don't think are there yet, but they've got promise. Mm-hmm. I think there's a script for If You Like School, You Love Work, kind of, it's been kicking about, which I think is very good.
Well, a combination of the short stories kind of thing?
Or? No, it's just the one about...
The actual story
about the guy in sort of in the Canary Islands, basically, yeah. So, yeah, I mean, so there's kind of potential for things to happen. We've also been talking about kind of doing a Skag Boys thing, a TV thing for Skag Boys with a kind of whole new cast. I wasn't interested in that idea, but there's a Trainspotting play that's doing the rounds now that was just in London, and it's gone back to the Edinburgh Festival. This In Your Face theatre group, and it's just these amazing kind of young actors that have taken this and have made it into something. They've kind of rebooted it for the contemporary era. And that got me quite excited, the idea of getting a sort of bunch of young actors together for TV and just going right through the sort of the Skag Boys Trainspotting kind of porno trilogy, basically.
Yeah.
So I think there's potential there.
You've done other plays. I mean, you've worked, you know, you had your play, You'll Have Had Your Hull some years ago. So any other plans to work on the stage?
Yeah. I mean, I like stage stuff. I mean, I enjoy doing it. There's a couple of, when I was taking the... When I was doing the Sex Lives of Siamese Twins on tour in America, I had a couple of actors, and they were kind of sort of like kind of young female actors who were much visually better than me for Americans, like to do this thing. So they did readings between them, and they kind of mixed it into almost like a kind of bit of a kind of play. It was like dialogue between them. So I'd like to do that as a play. We're talking about kind of maybe sort of doing staging that, basically.
Finally, just given the title of the book, I really have to ask, Irvine Welsh, are you a decent ride?
Well, what happened was I was absolutely kind of bowled over when they made these tickets for the tour, and it had like Irvine Welsh and then Colin, A Decent Ride. You know, I think my work here is done. You know, I've been saying this to everybody for years, and nobody's believed me, and now there it is. You know, I'm actually making tickets to advertise it. So, yeah, I mean, it's nice to get that recognition after all these years. Like, you know, although there's quite a few people who probably could call that into question. Like.
Irvine, thanks so much for talking to us, and best of luck with the book.